But her outward exhibitionism also served an inner purpose. I've never felt particularly comfortable with my body. I'm a bit curvy, you see, so I decided that if I could make people laugh with it, it might change my own feelings about the way I see myself. I was ill as a child, and I went from skinny to butterball. I've never completely lost it. Making people laugh, she believes, helped her accept herself. In 2014, Brandy found herself falling out of love with the job. You can't do this kind of work if you don't love it anymore. And so she quit and looked for something else to do with her life. But to be honest with you, I'm still looking. Of all the jobs I've done since, I've loved nothing even half as much. The stints as a waitress were temporary until something better came along. And though she shone at the work, she likens working in a pub to working in the theatre for its soap opera nature, and once made £800 in tips in 3 months, she craved greater fulfilment. This proved hard and soon took a toll. She grew disillusioned and increasingly empty. During our chat, the only time she doesn't maintain a steady eye contact is when talking about the depression she slipped into. Looking down at the palm of her hands, she says, "Oh, you know, there were some unpleasant relationships, weddings being called off, all sorts of nonsense like that. Basically, I stayed home for a year and didn't go out." In time, she found some solace of sorts in gardening. She had never done any gardening previously, but, she says, I just like being muddy. She began gardening locally for neighbours, then extended her reach beyond the neighbourhood. She found a job in a gardening business and is currently training for an RHS Level 2, which will teach her the principles of horticulture. But working freelance is difficult. "I've got the rent to pay, a family to help provide for. I needed a regular income." One afternoon, she found herself leafing through a magazine with friends and saw an article on naturist cleaning. Her friends laughed out loud, calling it ridiculous and insisting that they couldn't possibly imagine doing something like that. "In a million years,